hath read. Now, how many of y'all know that we like prophets and prophetesses that bring us good prophecies? We live in a world today where prophets are very, very, people are very skeptical. They don't, a lot of folk don't believe in the fivefold ministry. And the churches that do believe in prophets, that the acting role of a prophet within the fivefold ministry, they like to hear the good news all the time. You're going to get this, and God's going to bless you that, and you're going to get the desires of your heart here, and you're going to get this and that. Well, if you'll read Bible prophecy, the majority of it is not you're going to get the good stuff. Prophets, more so than office, did not say the good stuff. It's a hard role to fall into. This is the news that the prophet just told the people. God himself is speaking through her and say, I will bring evil upon this place and upon the inhabitants thereof. And verse 7, because thou hast forsaken me and have burned incense unto other gods, that they might provoke me to anger with all the works of their hands. Therefore my wrath shall be kindled against this place, and it shall not be quenched. In our age of tickle your ears and make you feel good, where you'll come back in churchiness, my desire is that we come together and help folk and beg and encourage and plead for them to escape the wrath of God, in doing it by accepting Jesus Christ, the man that made the way of escape. And this lady come with this message, y'all gonna be destroyed because he's very angry and you can't quench his fire. Look out, because you've disobeyed God and your fathers have. You're getting ready to be wiped out. Deliver that message. Huh? And more so than not, that's what prophets brought, wasn't it, Sparky? So now they got to take this back to the king. But to the king of Judah, which sent you to inquire of him, thus saith the Lord to him. Thus saith the Lord of Israel, as touching the words which thou hast heard. Because thine heart was tender, this is a message specifically to the king. Because thine heart was tender, and thou hast humbled thyself before the Lord, when thou hearest what I spake against this place, and against the inhabitants thereof, that they should become a desolation and a curse, and have rent thy clothes and wept before me, I have also heard thee, saith the Lord. Behold, therefore, I will gather thee unto thy fathers, and thou shalt be gathered into thy grave in peace, and thine eyes shall not see all the evil which I bring upon this place. And they brought the king word again. God spared not his anger and his wrath. He did spare the one that rent his clothes. Phil, come on. I surrender all, please, sir. Or that song, the second song that you did. Now, what an amazing story in the Word of God about how the works of the church were going, people were so busy without even having the Word of God. And my heart's desire is today is we put God's word before we do anything. What doth saith the word of the Lord concerning you right now, in your place, in the history of time that you're living right now? What is God speaking to you? We know, Pastor, I haven't spoken to you for a while. I'm kind of like the temple. I've been so busy with construction that I've kind of let the word get away from me a little bit. My temple has been breached. My temple is in ruin because I've misplaced the word of God. Stand to your feet with me as we come to a close. Bow your heads and close your eyes. Let's be in prayer just for a few moments. In this place all around, your temple is in disarray. You've tried to fix it with busyness. God is speaking to your heart on heart matters, but you've tried to do other things to try to pacify God. He's not pacified. He wants you to deal with the subject matter at hand, and that is your heart. anyone in this place at all that would like to deal with the subject matter of your heart, you figured out busyness doesn't cut it, you've pacified God with this and with that, and it doesn't work, He's not pacified. Your temple is in disarray, it's been broken, you've tried to fix it, and what you need to do is to get back to the Word of God. All over this place, if that will be you, I need for you to come toward this altar quickly. Step out of your seat. Quickly. 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 Come on. Come on. Come on. It's very, very easy to get busy with life. It's very, very easy to let the temple go for a while without maintenance. It's easy to get caught up in complacency and get caught up in things. Who else? Come on, church. Come on. Come on. Who would be brave enough and say, it's me. It's really me. I've neglected the important things when it comes to the things of God. I have neglected my temple. And it is in disarray. I need some prayer. I want to get back on track. I want to get the Word of God back in my life. I want to get the priority of God in my life. I want my priorities to be His priorities. Come on. Who else? Who else? If you haven't come, but you want to make this prayer from your seat, I want you to sing this. I surrender all to you. Let's worship together.
I surrender.
There's a gentleman getting ready to make a decision that's going to be the worst decision that you've ever made in your life. You've been thinking about it. You've been contemplating it. And the Holy Spirit is saying to you right now, don't do it. Don't do it. You've just about convinced yourself to follow through that which you've been thinking in your mind, even knowing that it's not a good decision, but yet you're so close to making a wrong decision. The Holy Ghost would say to you right now, don't do it. I'm telling you, that's serious. Don't you walk out that door and do what you've been thinking about doing. So much the presence of God. How many appreciate God?
Yes.
I appreciate you allowing me to stand before you. Has anybody been challenged this morning like I have?
Yes.
Amen. Let's get back to the Word of God. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Now, we've got a couple matters of business next door. Miss Susie is going to give you an opportunity to be of a service to our team. So we need for you to go over there and take a look at what that is. We've got some wonderful cookies by Sky and Faith Cookie Company that they have baked from scratch into wee hours of the night to help support in life in Kingsport. So whether you got money or whether you don't got money, come over there and eat some cookies. Make a donation, and Miss Susie wants to speak to all of us about an opportunity that she's going to present us with. Amen. We just appreciate the Lord so very much. I'm going to ask Mr. Brian Chapman if he'll come up here and dismiss us in the word of prayer.
Come on.
Again, letting us come to your house and visit with you today.
Yeah.
I pray that you will just let this message that you put on each and every one of us just dwell in our hearts over the next week. Let it stir us up. Let it change our lives, Lord. I pray that you'll just bless us as we go about our ways, as we go from here to there. And I pray that you'll just give us a chance to come back once again next week. In Jesus' name.